The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is. 7th chapter, text number 5. Given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Recorded on the 23rd of November, 1972, in Hyderabad, India.
Aparayamitasanyam prajjinne vidhime para jiva bhutan mahabaho jayidam dhajati javat. So, last night we discussed about the material energy and came to the conclusion that life is not made out of matter. Matter is product of living force, a living entity. Today it will be disturbing. Anyway, we shall explain. Now, that's all, I let them go, that question. Apara and para. Apara means inferior or material. And para means superior or spiritual. The spiritual force behind is moving the material world. Jayedam dhajati jagat. Jagat means gachati. It is jagat, which is moving or going forward. Everything is moving. All these planets are moving. Your earthly planet is also moving. Within 24 hours, covering 25,000 miles, day and night, the whole material planet, earthly planet, you have 25,000 miles, and this is rotating. Similarly, every planet is rotating. The sun is also rotating. Jasya advaya brahmati sang vritakala chakra. The sun is also having a duration of life, and it will rotate. Then it will be finished. Everything in the material world, it has got a date of birth. It lives for some time. It grows or changes the body and produces some byproducts, then dwindles and then vanishes. This is called sarvikar, six kind of changes of anything material. That is called jagat, gacchati. But there is a moving force, just like the motor car is going, gacchati. But the motor car is not moving without any driver. There is machine, very first-class machine, Rolls-Royce car, Cadillac car, good machine. But the machine is useless unless there is a driver. The aeroplane is moving, but without the pilot, it cannot move. Therefore, material elements, however, I'm so wonderful it may be, it has no value without the spirit soul. That is the explanation here. Aparayam. Krishna has explained the material elements, bhumi, rapo, nalo, vayu, khangama, no, buddhiri. But these material elements cannot work independently. It must be added with the superior energy or the living energy, jiva bhuta mahabhava, jayidam dhajati jagat. This Bombay city is important because there are so many living entities. Otherwise, where there are no living entities, even in Bombay, there are some open land. What is the value? There is no value. Therefore, the conclusion should be that material elements may be wonderful, but it has no value without the touch of living entities. The modern scientists, they cannot understand that there is living spiritual energy behind this material energy. Therefore it is moving. They are just like a child cannot understand that the motor car or the aeroplane is moving because there is driver and the pilot. Foolish children may think, oh, how the motor car is going on. The motor car is not going on independently. That the child does not know. Therefore, those who have no information of the spiritual energy behind the material energy, they are children, foolish children, mura. They have been described as mura. Naman duskitunam mura prapadante naradhama maya puritagyana asuri bhavamat. Therefore, foolish persons who cannot understand that behind this gigantic material energy, there is the spiritual energy, supreme spiritual energy, Krishna. They have no info. Therefore, in the previous verse, we have discussed, manushyanam sahasreshu kaschid jatati siddhaye jatatam visiddhyanam kaschid vetimam tattata. Ordinary person, they cannot understand that behind this gigantic, wonderful material energy, there is the supreme energy, spiritual energy, Krishna. They cannot understand. Just like the child cannot understand that the motor car is not moving independently, but there is a driver. These foolish materialistic person, they cannot understand. Māmeva paramabhyam. They cannot understand. Tri gunoi bhavai. They are bewildered by the three modes of material nature, finding out. Big, big scientists, big, big philosophers, big, big smarta, they are simply studying the material energy, but they have no information of the spiritual energy. Here, from the Bhagavad Gita, you can understand that this material energy is inferior, aparayam, aparayam. You cannot produce living force by combination of material energy. That is not possible. But they are, because these foolish persons, they are missing the spiritual energy. They are thinking by chemical reaction or by combination of matter, some living force is coming out. Just like if you mix acid and alkali, there is some reaction and there is some movement. They are thinking like that. No. It is not that. The material energy is being pushed forward by the spiritual energy. And jiva bhuta mahabhava, jiva, living force, jiva bhuta mahabhava. And because the spiritual force is there, the material world is working. This is the conclusion. Not that the material force is working independently. Aparayam itastu annyam. Annyam is different. It is not material energy. Annyam, completely. Prakriti, but it is prakriti. Not purusha. Purusha means the worker. Purusha is Krishna. Purusha is Krishna, as it will be admitted by Arjuna after hearing Bhagavad Gita. Purusham shasatam. Parabrahma param dhāma pavittam paramam bhavān. Purusha. You are purusha. Purusha means enjoyer and prakriti means enjoyer. So here, jīva, the living entities, they have been described as prakriti, not as purusha. The Mayavadi philosopher, they think the living entity is purusha, the supreme. But that is not the fact. A prakriti. Prakriti means subordinate energy. Acts under the direction of विपुरुषो प्रकृते क्रियमाणानि पुनः कर्माणि सर्वस देखिए मशीन इज मेड बाय ए पर्सन एंड द मशीन इज वर्किंग दैट मशीन इज वर्किंग दैट इज प्रकृति बट हु हैज मेड द मशीन आर पुशिंग ऑन द मशीन दैट इज पुरुष तो प्रकृते क्रियमाणानि गुणै कर्माणि सर्वस व्हेन यू सेट अप द मशीन जैसे इलेक्ट्रिसिटी यू सेट अप मशीन इज वर्क But the setter or who first sets the machine, pushes on the machine, that is a purusha. Similarly, the whole material world is working very nicely, wonderfully. But behind that machine, behind that working, there is Krishna. Maya dhaksena prakriti swate sachata. This is an electric powerhouse. You see, the machine is going on, is going on. But there is a supervising engineer. He is looking at whether the machine is rightly going on. If there is any defect, if there is oil required, he is putting some oil or something else. So the supervisor is the engineer. Similarly, the whole machine of this material world, all this material, you do not try to study the whole material world, but you study your own machine, this body. This body is also machine. Jantra rurani mayaya. Ishara sarvabhutanam riddeshe arjuna tishtati. Brahman sarvabhutani jantra rurani mayaya. This is a jantra, this body. Just like somebody sits you, just like a child is seated on the car and the car is moving. There are many examples. Similarly, this body is given by material energy. Jantra Rurani Maya. This body is given by Maya. But within the body, Dehi Nasmin Jatha Dehi. Dehi. Within the body, the living spirit or living soul is sitting there. And because we are under the control of Maya, we wanted it, such a body. So Krishna has given Hanumanta. He has given order to Maya that this living entity wants to enjoy this material world. Under certain body, so you give him this body. Just like a pig, he wanted to eat everything and anything without any discrimination. So, by the order of the Supreme, Hanumanta, Upadrashta, he orders to the Maya that you give him a body, a vehicle, a machine, a pig body, so that he can very nicely eat stew. So, this is karma, karma-bhas, that I want to possess a certain type of machine or body, and Krishna, Ishvara, is within everyone's heart. He understands, he is persistent to get this machine. All right, you get this machine. This is called janmanas, tathāte-hāntara-prāpti. In this way, we are desiring something, in this life, and the next life is being prepared. And that next life or this life, it is just like a machine. It is made by the material nature, under the order. Maya dhaksena prakriti swati sacharacharam hetunani na kaunteya jagat viparivartate. This is the fact. So, Krishna is the original purusha, prakriti. The material energy is also prakriti, subordinate to Krishna, and the spiritual energy, the living entity, they are also prakriti. But they are superior prakriti. Inferior matter, just like we are handling matter. We are getting matter, we are getting cement, we are getting bricks, we are getting iron, and combining them and making a very, very high skyscraper building. So the material energy is also Krishna's, and the spiritual energy, the living entity, that is also Krishna's energy. So, but they are working for satisfying their senses. Therefore, superior, jiva bhuta, jayedam dhajate, they are handling the material energy. The same living entity, when he understands his constitutional position, that I am part and parcel of Krishna, mama imaṃsa jiva bhuta, then he will work for Krishna. Then the same energy spent for building skyscraper building will be utilized to build a nice temple for Krishna. This is proper utilization of energy. When the energy of Krishna, the spiritual energy of Krishna, the living entity, works for Krishna, that is healthy condition. Just like part and parcel of my body, this finger, when this finger works for me, I want the finger, come here, works from here. But if the finger is not in healthy condition, it is painful, it cannot work. That is not normal condition. The normal condition is the finger is to work for my body. Similarly, we being part and parcel of Krishna, when we are engaged in Krishna's service, that is our normal condition, our healthy life. Therefore, Krishna says that these foolish creatures, murha, who are thinking that we shall work for sense gratification, they are murhas. Namaṁ duṣṭitinam murha, pravadvante narāma. The animals cannot understand this constitutional position of the living entity. Because this material world means all the living entities, they have come here for satisfying their senses. And in different grades of life, they are satisfying their senses, either as Brahma or the worm in the stool. They are satisfying their senses, different senses. That is material life. And when one understands that I am part and parcel of Krishna, my duty is to serve Krishna, that is normal life, that is actually spiritual life. Sevanamukhi jivbhadau svayam eva svaratvata. When you forget to serve Krishna, that is material life. And when we serve Krishna with love and affection, understanding that we are very intimately related, part and parcel, and that is spiritual life. This is the difference between material life and spiritual life. When one works for his own sense gratification, that is material life. And when one works for Krishna's satisfaction, that is spiritual life. That is spiritual. It is very easy to understand. We are working. We are servant of somebody. All these people who have gathered here, nobody can claim that I am not servant. Everyone is servant. Servant of the society, servant of the family, servant of the country, servant of dog, servant of cat. Everyone is servant. That is misplacement. But he is servant of Krishna. When he forgets that he is servant of Krishna, he becomes servant of so many maya. But when he understands that I am servant of Krishna, and becoming servant of Krishna, I can become servant of others also. That is called Krishna consciousness. This is the movement of Krishna consciousness. Everyone is a servant, but he is serving wrongly. His service is misplaced. We are simply educating people that your service means misplaced. Therefore, you are not satisfied, neither your master is satisfied. Nobody is satisfied. For example, I have repeated this example many times, even Mahatma Gandhi, the great servant of India, he served India so nicely, still the master was not satisfied and the master killed him. He wanted to serve his country, but the result was that his countrymen killed him. So this service is frustration. If you go on serving the material world, you will be frustrated. In this way or that way. But if you serve Krishna, the same sadhi applied to Krishna, your life will be successful. That is Krishna consciousness movement. You cannot avoid service, but service other than Krishna will be frustration. But if you serve Krishna, he will be satisfied, the Supreme Lord will be satisfied, and your life will be successful. Thank you very much.